It is now our zechus to be mechabed Harav Aaron Feldman Shlita, Roish HaYeshiva Yeshivas Ner Yisrael, Chaver Moyetzes Gedolei HaTorah, to be maschil the 14th machzer of Daf Hayomi.
Birshus Moronon v'Rabbonon v'Rabbeisai, Birshus this assembly of Oyavei Toiro, Birshus my dear brothers and sisters of Klal Yisrael who have completed this Shas. We say in davening every day, Vani zois b'risi omar Hashem, uchi asher olecho, udvorai asher samti b'ficho, le'amushu mipicho mipi zaracho ad olam. Hashem tells us, I have a covenant with you that my Torah, the words that I've given in your mouths, will never be lost from you forever. This day is a realization of that promise, that covenant which we have with HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that the words of Torah will never be lost. We've kept the Torah since Maamar Har Sinai. It has never left us. And today we celebrate this connection we have with Ruchi Asher Alecho, Udvorai Asher Samti Beficho, Uyamushu Mipicho, Mipi Zaracho Ad Olam. The Mishnah we are about to begin, Me'emasai, teaches us when the time for the reading of Shema in the evening begins. This Mishnah, besides being the first in Shas, is also the beginning of two other subdivisions of Shas. It's the beginning of Seder Zeroyim, the first of the six Dorim of Shas. Secondly, it's the beginning of Mesechta Brochas, the first Mesechta in Shas. Zeroyim deals with the laws of the produce of the fields. It tells us which portions we have to separate from our produce to give to the Kohanim, the Levim, and the poor. Masechta Brochos deals with the blessings we must recite before we partake of our food. Remarkably, there is a great difficulty in this. This Mishnah that we're about to begin seems to be unrelated to both of them. What does Kriya Shema have to do with Zeroyim, the produce of the fields? What does Kriya Shema have to do with the blessings we make over our food? Why then should Me'emasai serve as their beginnings? A more basic question deserves to be asked. Why was this Mishnah chosen out of all the other Mishnayos to be placed at the head of all of Shas? Seder Zeroyim, as we have said, deals with our obligation to separate a portion of our produce as gifts for the Kohanim, Levim, and the poor. With these gifts, we demonstrate that the earth is not ours, but Hashem's. We demonstrate that we cannot use our land until we first give a portion of its produce to those whom Hashem has designated. Similarly, regarding brochas, the pleasures of this world are gifts bestowed upon us by Hashem, and we must express our gratitude to Him for those gifts by making brochas before we partake of them. Put into other words, Seder Zeroyim says that the earth is not ours. Masechta Brochos says that the world is not ours. Kriya Shema goes a step further. It says that our lives are not ours. Shema Yisrael, Hashem Elokeinu, Hashem Echad, says that there is one source of existence, one purpose to life. It goes on with V'ohavto to say that we must obey the will of one Creator, and therefore we must even give up our lives under certain circumstances and our possessions rather than violate Hashem's will. The recognition that the sole purpose of our lives is to serve Hashem is therefore the logical beginning of Zvoyim and of Masechet Brachos. Because serving Hashem is the reason for our existence, because of that, our fields are His, our food is His. We must therefore separate Truma Maisa from our fields before we enjoy its fruits. We must therefore express our gratitude to Hashem for every morsel of food we enjoy. If so, this Mishneh stands rightfully at the beginning of Seder Zroim and Masechet Brachos. Kriya Shema tells us that our lives belong to Hashem, and therefore the earth and all that is on it belong to Him as well. Because this idea is so basic to everything in Judaism, this is why this Mishneh Me'emasai was chosen to be the first Mishneh of Shas. Shas is the blueprint of Jewish life. Kriya Shema tells us that the purpose of our lives is to live by this blueprint. Once we know what is our purpose, we can go on to carrying out that purpose. There is another first in Kriya Shema. After informing us of what our mission in life is, Kriya Shema goes on to say, "V'hayu ha'dvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecho hayoyim al levavecho." This is the mitzvah to study Torah. We are being told that we can only accomplish our mission in life if we commit ourselves to learning Torah. If life is here to serve Hashem, the only way we can know what is Hashem's will is to study Torah. This gathering, probably the greatest since the Churban Beis HaMikdash, is a recognition by Rivavas Alfei Yisrael, multitudes of Jews, of what Torah means to the Jewish people. It is a statement that Torah is central to our existence as Jews. It is an expression of the words we say before reading the Shema every evening, Ki Heim Chayenu V'Erech Yomenu. Torah is our life and the length of our days. Torah is the lifeblood of the Jewish people. As we begin a new cycle of Shas, let us commit ourselves to the study and to the support of as much Torah as we are able. Without the learning of Torah and its support, we cannot survive either as individuals or as a nation. With this in mind, let us begin the Mishneh Me'emasai. When does the time for reading the Shema begin? Me'emasai kohen Shema ba'arvis mishor sha'kohanim nichnosim lechol b'trumoson atzoyf ha'shmoyr ha'rishon yadivir ha'belezer. When do we start reading the Shema in the evenings? From the time that the kohanim begin eating the truma, if they're had to be toivel in a mikveh during the day, at soifu ha'shmoyr ha'rishon, until the first third of the night. Divrei Rebbelezer. Why doesn't the Mishnah say from the time that night falls? Why does it say, why do we give the time as related to the time when Kohanim can eat the truma? I believe, in accordance with what we said before, that because we read Kriya Shema, therefore we have to give truma. Our lives are not ours, and our produce is not ours. But the Chachomim say, "Ad chatzos." You can only read till midnight. Rabbi Gamliel omer shiyaleh lomer shachar, until dawn. Maseh ubo bonu beis hamishteh. It happened that the children of Rabbi Gamliel once came from a celebration. Omru loy, they said to him, loy karinu es shema. We didn't read the shema yet. Omru lahem, im loy olo amra shachar, chayovim atem likros. If the dawn has not happened yet, you are required to read Kriya Shema. Even though the Chachomim say ad chatzois, but that doesn't mean that the Torah obligation ends at chatzois. The Torah obligation ends when dawn arrives. Whenever the Chachomim said that you should do something until midnight, mitzvoson at sheyala amar shachar. If you didn't do it through midnight, you can still do it until the morning. Hekter chalovim veivorim, the offering of the fats on the mizbeach, and the evorim of the korban oilo on the mizbeach all night, mitzvoson at sheyala amar shachar. You're supposed to do it until the morning, if you haven't done it until chatzos. V'chol anecholim liyom echod. Any korban which you're allowed to eat only for one day, means you can only eat it the day that you shechted the korban and the night until the next dawn. You must eat it until chatzos. But if you haven't eaten until chatzos, you can wait until the morning, and you can eat it before then. Im kein lo mom chachom chatzos. Why did the Chachamim say till chatzos? De lahachik es odem na'avera. So the person should be distance himself from na'avera. Esther Gemara Tona hechekoi diktona meimasai. What is the Mishnah referring to when it says meimasai? The su maishna de tona ba'arvis bereisha listen to shachet bereisha. Why is the kriyashma of the night mentioned first? Why not the kriyashma of the day? Tona akrokoi. The pasuk, the Tana refers to a pasuk which says b'shochbecho u'kumecho. You're supposed to read Kriya Shema first b'shochbecho u'kumecho. The order is first the evening, and then the day. V'bo yiseime yalav v'biriyase shaloylam yichsiv v'yera v'yivoyker yemechot. Baruch Hashem, we began Shas again, Bezos Hashem, when we be zoiche, the next inclusion of Shas should be Yerushalayim HaKodesh, Vinyan Beis HaMikdosh, Me'erav Yomeinu Amen.